I'm Warren Smith with the Colson Center. Thanks for listening. I want to remind you that you can help keep Breakpoint on the air by going to breakpoint.org and hitting the Give button at the top of the page. Now, enjoy today's episode.
One left-leaning magazine just described how sad it is when people resort to surgery to cure their dysphoria. But I guess not all dysphorias are equal. For the Colson Center, I'm John Stone Street. This is Breakpoint. A recent story in New York Magazine asked readers how many bones they'd be willing to break in order to attain intimacy, or something to that effect. They weren't referring to injuries from fighting with another man over a woman. They were referring to cosmetic surgery. Nor were they referring to surgery performed on an older man to make him look younger. No, they were referring to surgeries performed on young 20-something men who hate the way they look and are convinced that they're doomed to involuntary celibacy unless they go under the knife. Such men are known as incels, which is described as an online community of men united by their inability to convince women to have intimate relations with them. Incels is short for involuntary celibates. The central character in this article goes by the moniker Truth for Lie. This young man in his 30s has spent time in a psychiatric hospital. He's exchanged blows with his father. He even punched his sister in the head as a child. To put it gently, he's got some problems. However, after spending time on incel forums, Truth for Lie became convinced that his real problem was his appearance. His friends and family, on the other hand, are convinced that he suffers from body dysmorphic disorder, which is an extreme anxiety about an imagined physical defect that others often cannot see. People with this disorder often resort to plastic surgery to try to improve their appearance. That's exactly what Truth for Lie did. In 2016, he flew from the Netherlands to Indianapolis to see a surgeon who specializes in what's called aesthetic surgery. He returned to Indianapolis 3 times in the next year in pursuit of an ideal face. As he told New York Magazine, the prospect of a better surgery result is keeping me alive. Now, we're clearly intended to see Truth for Lie as a sad, even pathetic figure, according to this article. To further drive home the point, the article notes how many cosmetic surgeons refuse to operate on people if they suspect that they suffer from body dysmorphic disorder. Surgery is not a cure for a psychiatric disorder. But of course, gender dysphoria is another psychiatric disorder. In this condition, a person experiences discomfort or distress because there's a mismatch between their biological sex and their gender identity. As with body dysmorphic disorder, people who suffer from gender dysphoria often suffer from other psychiatric illnesses, such as major depressive disorders and various phobias. A study published in 2014 found this was true of 62% of the people studied. Now, there's an obvious question here for our culture. If surgery will not solve Truth for Lies' psychiatric problems, why are we so certain that surgery is the solution for those suffering with gender dysphoria? After all, a 2011 study of Swedes who had sex reassignment surgery found that persons with transsexualism after sex reassignment have considerably higher risks for mortality, suicidal behavior, and psychiatric morbidity than the general population. Increasingly today, the message is that nothing should keep someone with gender dysphoria from the surgeon's blade except maybe hormone treatment, and that includes children. Anyone who ever suggests otherwise, that those who suffer from gender dysphoria might consider some sort of intervention, maybe even counseling, well, they're quickly accused of transphobia. The obvious parallels between incels and those with gender dysphoria, as well as our culture-wide suppression of those obvious parallels, would be funny if the consequences weren't so tragic. Because ideas have consequences, and bad ideas have victims. And the idea that our looks, our so-called gender identity, even our psychiatric disorders define who we are, boy, that's a victim maker if there ever was one. For Breakpoint, I'm John Stone Street.
I'm Warren Smith with the Colson Center. You can help keep commentaries like the one you just heard on the air by going to breakpoint.org and hitting the Give button at the top of the page. Thanks for your support.